Managing user access in your SAP Public Cloud environment can pose you with serious challenges. Think about it for a moment. Today, we will provide you with a better understanding of the importance of user provisioning and elaborate on the options. So let's get started. Good day, everyone. My name is seyhan.uzun and I work for McCoy and Partners as a SAP Security and Authorizations Consultant. Today, I would like to share some insights on a crucial aspect of the SAP Public Cloud implementation, which is user provisioning. User provisioning plays a very important role in managing access to this powerful platform. Let's quickly dive into the heart of the subject. In order to visualize my story, hereby an illustration about SAP Public Cloud. In this illustration, you can see that the SAP Public Cloud hosts different solutions. I will not mention them all, but some flavors are SAP Ariba, Business Technology Platform, SAP C4HANA, and SAP Analytics Cloud. What is user provisioning in SAP Public Cloud? User provisioning in SAP Public Cloud refers to the process of management of systems access to the users and provisioning those users with the authorizations required to execute their work in a secure way. This includes creating user accounts and mapping the roles to the users. The key point here is that the user provisioning is not only a matter of efficiency, but also of security and compliance. With SAP Public Cloud, organizations can streamline these processes, improve productivity while maintaining control and security. It provides a flexible and adaptable solution that enables businesses to quickly and securely provide access to the right people at the right time. Now, let's highlight the relationship with identity and access management. SAP Public Cloud integrates seamlessly with identity and access management platform by giving organizations centralized control and clarity on user access. This strengthens security and simplifies management. A well-integrated identity and access management solution combined with effective user provisioning in SAP Public Cloud helps organizations minimize security risks and ensure regulatory compliance. Apart from user provisioning, identity and access management provides also other features for applications and systems. Those are streamlined user account creation, streamlined user account disablement, centralized user account information management, centralized user account access management, and enable self-service password reset functionality. Let's demonstrate this in a real situation. I will describe the process of the onboarding of a new employee in Company X, with focus on access to the SAP Public Cloud for the user. At first, HR onboards a new employee. HR assigns the new employee to a specific function and department. Following this registration, a user is created. Based on the function and department information, specific roles are provisioned to the user, for example, for intranet and time registration access. A user may have one function in HR terms, but may have different roles in the organization. Therefore, authorizations in multiple sub-cloud systems may be required. For example, a sales office employee may need access to both C4 and S4 systems for his or her daily job because C4, customer experience, and S4, ERP systems serve different but complementary functions in the sales process. Overall, having access to both C4 and S4 systems allows sales office employees to provide better customer service, manage sales effectively, and ensure a smooth end-to-end sales process. In conclusion, the relationship between user provisioning in SAP Public Cloud and identity and access management is vital. Identity and access management is the framework for managing identities, while user provisioning is an important building block. Together, they provide organizations with the ability to manage access efficiently, securely, and in compliance with regulations. If this video triggers you to gain more information, do not hesitate to contact me on the email shown below. Also, you can still watch my previous video about Fiori Spaces and Pages. Thanks for watching and have a good day.